In the last lecture, we have studied about pumping lemma for context-free languages, and in this lecture, we will be taking an example to see and figure out how the pumping lemma for context-free languages actually works. So here we have an example language given, L equal to a power n, b power n, c power n, where n is greater than or equal to 0. So the meaning of this language is that we can have symbols of the form A, B, C, and then the number of A's should be equal to the number of B's, and it also should be equal to the number of C's. That means if you have n number of A's, you should also have n number of B's and also n number of C's. So it means the number of A, B, and C should always be the same. That is the rule of this language that we have. So our task is to show that this language is not context-free, and we will do this using pumping lemma for context-free languages. So let's see what are the steps that we need to follow. So the first step is we will assume that the language L is context-free. And why are we doing this? We studied in the previous lecture that the way we are going to prove this is using contradiction. So first we will assume that L is context-free, and we will show that there is a contradiction to our assumption and hence it is not context-free. So we'll see how we do that. So first we have this language L, and we assume that it is context-free. So, if it is context-free, then the language L must have a pumping length. This also we studied, and we will call the pumping length P. And now we will take a string S such that S is equal to A power P, B power P, and C power P, where P is our pumping length. And then we have to divide S into 5 parts U, V, X, Y, and Z. So let us just look at the rules of this pumping lemma that we studied in the previous lecture, just to recall those. So this is the rule of pumping lemma that we studied in the previous lecture. And we said that if a language is context-free, then it will have a pumping length. So we already assumed that our language is context-free, so it will have a pumping length P. And then we have to divide our language into 5 pieces, U, V, X, Y, and Z, which we will do. And after dividing that, you have to show that U, V, raised to I, X, Y raised to I, Z also belongs to the same language for every I greater than 0. So this condition must hold if the language is context free. And also condition 2 and 3 must hold. So we will focus on condition number 1. So let's go back to our problem. So here we have taken P as our pumping length, and we are going to divide our string S into 5 parts, U, V, X, Y, and Z. So let's see how we can do this. So here, for example, I have taken the pumping length P is equal to 4. You can take any other length also, but here, for example, we have taken our pumping length P, which is equal to 4. And so we have the string A power P, B power P, C power P. So all the P's, I replace it with 4. So I have my string of the form A power 4, B power 4, and C power 4. So this is the string that we have, and our next step is to divide the string S into parts U, V, X, Y, and Z. So let's see how we can divide it. There are two cases. Case number 1. V and Y each contains only one type of symbol. So what do I mean by this? I'll show you. So here I've taken this string A 4 times, B 4 times, and C 4 times. So this is the string that we have. Now I'm going to divide it into U, V, X, Y, and Z such that V and Y each contains only one type of symbol. So let's see. I will take these two A's. This part will be my V. And then I will take this C over here, just this one C, and this will be my Y part. So what will be the remaining one? This A over here, this is my U, and this A, B, 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 and up to this C, this is my X, and this two C's over here, this is my Z. So I have divided my string into U, V, X, Y, and Z. And the case that we had was that V and Y each contains only one type of symbol. So where is my V? This is my V, and V contains only A, the same kind of symbols. And what about Y? Y also contains only one kind of symbol, which is C. So each V and Y, it contains only one type of symbols. So that is one case or one way in which you can divide it into parts U, V, X, Y, and Z. Now after we have divided, we said that the condition number 1 was saying that u v raised to I x y raised to I z must also belong to the language. So here I have I over here, and I am going to take I is equal to 2, for example. So if I take I equal to 2, that means it will be u v square x y square and z. Now let me replace it here and see what is the kind of string that I am going to get. So if I do this, u, what is my u? U is just 1a. And what is my v? V contains 2a's, but it is v square, so I have to double it. That means there will be 4a's. A, 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 A. Then x, what is my x? A, B, 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 C. A, B, 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 C. And then I have y square. What is my y? Y is just 1c, but since it is square, I have to double it, so there will be 2c's. And then z. Z contains 2c's over here. C, C. Alright, so this is the string that we get. Now let me count how many a's are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 number of a's, and how many b's? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 number of b's, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 number of c's. So this is the string that I am getting. So here I see that a is 6, b is 4, and c is 5. The number of a's is not equal to the number of b's, and that is also not equal to the number of c's. So the rule of our language said that the number of a's, b's, and c's should always be the same. But when I divided my string into u, v, x, y, and z, and when I raised this v and y to the power of 2, the string that I am getting does not belong to the language L, because the resultant string that I get here has different number of a's, b's, and c's. So this does not belong to the language L. So this shows that condition number 1 cannot be satisfied. So since condition number 1 cannot be satisfied, we see that our assumption, which said that L is context free, does not hold. It is a contradiction to our assumption. If L was supposed to be context free, then the string that I get here should also belong to the language L, but it is not belonging to the language L when I do this. So our condition number 1 itself fails. If you want, you can check conditions number 2 and 3 also, but since 1 already failed, so there is no point in actually checking 2 and 3. So from condition number 1 itself, we found that it is a contradiction to our assumption, which said that L is context free. So we can say that L is not a context free language from case number 1. Now we can have another case. Let's see what that is. Okay, the case number 2 says that either V or Y has more than one kind of symbols. So this is my string, 4 number of A's, 4 number of B's, 4 number of C's. Now I'm going to divide it into 5 pieces, U, V, X, Y, and Z, such that either the part V or the part Y has more than one kind of symbols. So let me see how I can do this. So here, this one, the 2 A's from here and the 2 B's from here, this will be my V. And then this B over here, this will be my Y. So why am I concentrating mostly on the V and the Y part? Because these are the two parts which we are going to raise them to powers. So that is why I am focusing mainly on V and Y. So either V or Y has more than one kind of symbols. This is my V, and in my V, it contains both A's and B's. There are two kind of symbols. There are more than one kind of symbols. And Y contains only one B. That is fine. So here, this is the condition where at least one of the part among V or Y should contain more than one kind of symbols, which is this one, where V contains more than one kind of symbols, A and B. Now, what will be the remaining part? This will be my U. This is U, V, and this B over here, this will be my X. And the remaining part, this C's, will be my Z. Now, let us see if we raise them to the power, what will happen. U, V raised to I, X, Y raised to I, Z, and again I will take I is equal to 2. So this also you can vary it, you can take some other numbers also, but I am just taking the example of 2. So here let's see, U, V square, X, Y square, Z, because the value of I is 2. Now let's see what will happen. What is my U? U contains two A's, AA and V square. What is my V? V contains AABB, but it is square, so I have to write this two times, AABB, AABB, and again AABB. And then X, what is my X? It is just B. And Y square, what is Y? Y contains just one B, but since it is square, I have to write it twice. And Z contains four number of C's. 1, 2, 3, 4. So here, this is the string I am getting. And what is the pattern of this string? There are A's followed by two B's, and again A is repeating, and then again we have some number of B's and some number of C's. But the language that we had, the L that we had, should be of the form A power N, B power N, C power N. This should be the pattern that should be followed. You should first have N number of A's followed by N number of B's and N number of C's. But here, after you have A's, you have B, and again you are having A's. So this pattern is not being followed. So we can say that this string also does not belong to the language L. So even when you divide it in this way, taking this case into consideration, the resultant string that you get does not belong to our language L. So since this does not belong to our language L, our condition number 1, it fails. And since the condition number 1 fails, there is no point in checking condition number 2 and 3. If you want, you can check it, but since 1 itself fails, it is a contradiction to our assumption that L is a context-free language. So since it fails, we can say that our assumption that L is a context-free language does not hold, and hence this language L is not context-free. So this is the way, using pumping lemma for context-free language, you can prove that a given language is not context-free. So I hope this was helpful to you. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.